Patrick Murphy, an Iraq War veteran. He is with U.S. troops today there in Kuwait. Undersecretary Murphy, it is an honor and a privilege to be talking to you. I know the men and women around you can't hear me, but please turn around to them and say thank you for me and for all of us, and happy Thanksgiving.
All right. CNN just gave you all a shout out and say you're best looking soldiers in the world. Thank you very much. Let's let them know. And they're going to take that compliment. And they are just... Listen, these men and women are away from their friends and their families this Thanksgiving, but they love their country, and they're doing everything they can to make sure our families at home in America are safe.
Tell me about your day. I know it's almost 3 o'clock in the afternoon where you are, so am I correct in saying you have already had your turkey? Tell me what the day has been like so far.
Yeah, you called me. I'm up. I had two servings of turkey, and I didn't get the food coming yet. I'm having a lot of caffeine, but we trained even on Thanksgiving. We did a 5K run. We did a turkey trot this morning, and this is another work day for these soldiers, except we make sure we provide lots of turkey, lots of pumpkin pie, etc. What's great is these soldiers are doing what they love, and that's serving their country, and they're hoping they're making all the families, and especially their families back at home, proud of their efforts, because we're asking these soldiers, less than 1% of America, to deploy during the longest wars in American history in Afghanistan and Iraq. Now, I'm talking to you from Kuwait, but just north of here is where our soldiers and the Iraqi army specifically is taking the fight to ISIS in Mosul. And we have a lot to be proud of the gains that they're making.
I want to ask you about Mosul in just a second, but looking at you and all the men and women reminds me, I was privileged and honored to spend a couple of days on an aircraft carrier in the spring with the Navy, with a bunch of soldiers. And I think what struck me was I'm not trying to get a new rivalry here. No, our Army-Navy.
I know,
just
but
hang
listen,
with me.
We're the America's varsity team. You hang out with the Navy, but it's okay.
But that said, I think it was fascinating to me understanding the sense of purpose for serving this country, and also, how in touch with their families they were. What would the men and women around you want their families to know on this holiday?
Yeah, and when I was here 13 years ago as a soldier, as a captain with the 82nd Airborne Division, and so these soldiers are able to Skype home, to do FaceTime, to call home more frequently, not as much as they would like, but they want their families to know that they're serving, and they're serving, and they're part of the 1% of America, or frankly less than 1%, that's willing to stand in the way of ISIS and them doing any harm or any more harm to our families back at home, and giving the Iraqis a chance. I mean, what people don't realize is that the Iraqi army, with our help and our partnership, has been able to liberate over 500,000 Iraqis and Syrian from the scourge of ISIS, which is just a terrorist organization which is doing horrible things, not just here in Iraq and Syria and Afghanistan, but also obviously in our own America with San Bernardino and other
right.
instances.
Undersecretary Murphy, what about, you mentioned Mosul a moment ago. Can I just ask you an update? How is that fight progressing?
What you see in Mosul right now is the most, which is Iraqi army led. What you're seeing is the largest combat operation since we took Baghdad in 2003. That was 13 years ago. So, what you're seeing now is really a true partnership. You have the Iraqi army, you have the Turkey, you have the Kurds, you have really different players in the region stepping up, taking it and say, listen, ISIS does not represent Islam. ISIS is not welcome here anymore. So our partnership with the Iraqi army, they've taken out ISIS in Ramadi and Fallujah. We're now focused on Mosul. So that's the largest, again, that's where basically ISIS's capital in Iraq is, Mosul. So we're gonna take them out. And after that, we're taking out their capital in Raqqa in Syria, because we can't let ISIS walk the face of this earth and do harm to other Americans and also our partners here in Iraq and in Syria.
Final question, sir. We're separated by thousands of miles, but what do you want the rest of us to know about what you all are doing back here at home?
Well, everyone has families back at home. And, I know it's my daughter, my daughter's 10 years old today, Maggie Murphy. But we all are sacrificing, them more than me. I'm only here for a week for the Thanksgiving to make sure that I'm saying thanks on behalf of our nation back at home. But, what I would like Americans to know is these folks, they're civic assets. They can be doing anything they want in this world. Our veterans are more likely to be employed than non-veterans. They're more likely to start a small business and for that small business to be successful. than non-veterans. I mean, they're more likely to vote in elections, no matter what their political persuasion is, than non-veterans, because they love their country. They take an oath to support and defend the Constitution and the values that we represent as Americans. This is the face of America right here overseas, and we have a lot to be proud of. And so when you see soldiers back at home, at the Red Lobster, Olive Garden, wherever, at the mall, you know, just say thank you and ask them, you know, hey, where'd you serve? What are you doing? What's next for you? You know, just have a conversation, because they're just like us. You know, when I joined at 19, I remember people asked me, Patrick, why would you join? You know, you're on a dean's list in college. I was the captain of the college hockey team. And I said, because I want to serve my country. You know, my dad served. You know, my grandfather served. You know, it's become sometimes too much of a family business, but we need the next generation of men and women to stand up and be part of America's varsity team, the United States Army.
I cannot thank you enough, and the men and women around you. This is one of the most important conversations we'll have all day. Thank you all so much, and happy Thanksgiving once again.
Thanks. Happy Thanksgiving to you, too.
Thank you. Thank you very much. We are following a lot of news. Let's get to it.